Do you want to understand the test behavior at first glance? Maybe you want to try our graphical editors and create organized flows. Hi, my name is Matthias Lutsch and I'm a software development engineer at Vector. My baby is vTESTstudio and today I'm going to show you its graphical design editors. First, I want to give you an overview about the usability of our graphical editors. These are options to create abstract and UML-like test designs. Test cases are generated either on the transitions or path of the diagrams and show a complete test coverage. The state diagram editor and the test sequence diagram editor are of a similar structure and the handling is comparable. In the toolbox, you can find all graphical elements for the test design and documentation. You can drag and drop the elements into the diagram, or you can double-click on it and it is locked for permanent use. Additional information like variable values and test case attributes that are relevant for the test environment can be edited in the command editor. This is the table that appears at the bottom of the diagram if you click in the empty space. At the same position, test case commands can be added when an element is focused. In the lower right corner, there is, besides the zoom functionality, a button to navigate through the diagram overview that can be useful for bigger diagrams. Now let's have a deeper look into the state diagram. The state diagram is a useful approach to implement tests by defining states and their transitions. It must start with an initial element and every path must lead to a final element, as you can see it here. The states define test commands to check the actual state of the system under test, and the transitions contain the stimulation that trigger the state change. With the context menu or the button in the ribbon bar, the path view can be quickly opened for the diagram. The algorithm for the path generation can be changed between breadth first search and Chinese postman. The generated test cases for the state diagram travel all transitions at least once. This means that we provide transition coverage. The Chinese postman results in long but efficient paths. The breadth first search generates small paths, which are better to reproduce and debug. The second editor I'm introducing today is the test sequence diagram editor. It can be used to describe the test procedure by creating a flow through the elements and ensure that every combination is tested. Like the state diagram, it must contain one start element. You can also see that the diagram elements are connected by transitions, which can contain stimuli. Multiplexer can split the sequence based on variation points, like the velocity of the vehicle or lock state. Check elements make sure that certain conditions are met, like the doors are unlocked. To merge paths, you can use the join element. And the end of the path is ensured by a finalless element. Your generated test cases ensure path coverage, which means that for every possible path, a test case is generated. So, the state diagram and test sequence diagram editors are two ways to generate test cases based on graphical elements that are intuitive to understand. These diagram editors also support easy communication with other stakeholders like the requirement engineer. I think they are helpful to keep an overview of the test structure, and I hope you like them as much as I do. Thank you for watching! Interested in more videos on vTESTstudio or other Vector products? Then please subscribe to our Vector Tech Tutorial channel, activate the bell, and never miss a new video again. See ya!